Hello everybody, welcome to Mr. Wisp here again. So in this video I want us to take a look at another bandwidth management protocol, which is PCQ. And just before I forget, in my last video I forgot to mention something which is really important, and that is for you to have all these queues to work and be effective. And this also applies for the PCQ that we want to configure right now. Just make sure that your fast track is disabled, because if fast track is enabled, the queues will not be able to work. So just note that, please. So for PCQ, basically PCQ is a per connection queue, and it's a queue discipline where the bandwidth that you have is gets distributed equally among the number of people or clients that you have. So that's the beauty of PCQ. And let's say for instance you have a, let's say maybe a decent 50 meg link. So if you have two clients, this 50 meg is going to be divided equally to each and every one of these two clients. That means each and every one of them is going to get 25 meg. So that is how PCQ works, and it's really, really helpful, because let's say for instance where you are just running simple queues, because with simple queues we'll find a situation where probably you have one or two persons who are hogging the whole bandwidth, and this really affects the rest of the people. So with PCQ that will not happen. So we are going to use I'm still using GNS to show you this. So let's log into our MikroTik router, and for us to get PCQ running we need to also add a few Mangle rules and do some little configuration on our queue tree as well. So the first thing that we need to do is we need to come to queues, and you can see we have queue tree here. You have an option of either editing any of these or creating your own. So let's create our own. So let's come to add, and then let's call this maybe PCQ download, let's say policy. And the kind of queue this is going to be PCQ, and the rate this is going, we were talking of 50 meg, so that is you put it under the rate. And then PCQ uses classifiers to determine to differentiate a download policy and an upload policy. So for the download policy you need to check the destination address. Excuse me. So that is all that you need to do, and then you click on apply and okay to that. Then let's create another policy for upload. So let's call this PCQ upload policy, the kind of queue this is a PCQ, and our rate is the 50 meg that we were talking about. And now for the upload we use the source address, then apply that and okay. So after that we need to have some two Mangle rules. So let's come to IP firewall, then come to the Mangle tab, then click on the add. So this is going to be a pre-routing chain, and our in interface is going to be our WAN. The in interface is going to be our WAN, and then you come to the action tab, and the action, this is going to be mark paket. And the new paket mark, let's call this download mark. Then apply that. Okay. Then we are going to have another rule which is going now to affect our upload. So on the general tab, the chain is still going to be pre-route as well. And our in interface this time round, this is now going to be our LAN interface. And the action for this is also going to be mark paket. And let's just give it a name, upload mark. Apply. Okay, so basically what we have are just two simple Mangle rules of traffic which is coming in and traffic which is going out. So let's get this out of the way. So the next thing that you now need to do is you need to come to... So when you come to the queue tree, you just click on add. So let's call this all bandwidth. The parent is going to be global, and we are going to set the max limit here to 50 m, that is all the total bandwidth that we have, and we are just going to leave it as that. This is now going to be our general bandwidth. So you click apply. Okay, then after that you need to come and add a new queue. So we can call this maybe download, and the parent, let's use this to be all bandwidth. And then now the paket marks, the Mangle rules that we created, now comes to play. So the paket mark, we are now going to choose the download mark that we created, and then just click apply. Okay, let's do the same for upload. So you come and add another, and then let's just call this upload, and then the parent is going to be all bandwidth, and then we choose the paket mark that we created, that is our upload mark, and then apply that. Okay, so this is basically how you do the configuration for that. So basically what happens is whatever number of clients you have connected to your MikroTik router, these people are going to be able to share these 50 meg equally, and it's not going to be biased to one person or something like that. I'm using GNS3 to run this. So definitely we can't really see it's how effective it is, but when you apply this to your live network where you have clients connected, you have other CPEs connected, you're definitely going to see how it works. So guys, that is all for today. Be sure to like my videos, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.